إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. And every going astray and every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى وآتاكم من كل ما سألتموه وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها إن الإنسان لظلوم كفار. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran what means, and He gave you all that you asked for. And if you were to count the blessings of Allah, the favors of Allah, the gifts from Allah, never would you be able to count them all. You would be missing scores, millions of them. Verily, man is indeed an extreme wrongdoer, a disbeliever, denying Allah's blessings by disbelief, by worshipping others besides Allah, and by disobeying Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When we count Allah's blessings and favors, we constantly miss hundreds of thousands, taking for granted every breath and every beat of every organ that we have. But when we do count, when there's those of us who do remember Allah's blessings and Allah's favors and Allah's gifts, we mention so many, but we forget that the guidance to this deen, being upon al-Islam, being Muslim, was and is the best gift that we were ever given. The greatest gift Allah bestowed upon us is the blessing, the ni'mah of Islam. Allah said, أَلْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَدِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. Allah says what means, this day I have perfected for you your religion. And I have completed, أَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي, I have completed my favor upon you. Upon you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, upon the Muslims, upon the Ummah at large. I have completed the favor for you by giving you Islam and have chosen for you al-Islam as your religion. The day of Arafah, when this ayah was revealed, was the day our deen was completed and perfected for us. In essence, giving us the greatest blessing of all time, al-Islam. And we will never be able to thank Allah enough for this enormous gift of Islam. Ibn Kathir, he said about this ayah, this is the greatest, Ibn Kathir said, the greatest blessing and favor that Allah could have ever done for you in your life. Everything you lose on this earth, it doesn't matter, because at one point it will all go. Everything will perish. كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. Everything on the earth, whatsoever is on the earth, will perish, die, stop by Allah's permission, and the face of your Lord, full of majesty and honor, will abide forever. But if you get to that next life, obviously you will have left behind all your material possessions, everything you amassed of wealth and property and good things, jewelry and the likes of these matters. and you would have left this dunya. If you have left this dunya while abandoning Allah and abandoning Islam, then you will have achieved the greatest loss. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Allah says what means, and whoever seeks a religion other than Islam, it will never be accepted of him or her. And in the hereafter, he will be one of the losers. Those of us who are born Muslim, those who reverted back into Islam, even with time, they often take for granted and fail to truly appreciate the deen that we've been blessed with. To worship our Creator alone without partners. Of all of the blessings given, health, wealth, family, loved ones, a sound mind, the greatest of these blessings without a doubt is the guidance and belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Islam is the greatest blessing we have. If you were to lose your mother and your father, your wife or your spouse and your children, if you were to lose all whom you loved, all of your wealth, everything you got, it would not even compare. It would not even closely compare to losing Allah or losing Islam as your deen. Inna deena 'inda Allah al-Islam. The religion with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Islam. Till the end of time. And the only one he will accept on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And this is an obligation we need to remind ourselves with. To teach this to those whom we care about and those whom we love. To bring up our children upon this. And Abdullah ibn Umar, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ألا كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, each one of you is a shepherd and each of you will be responsible for his or her flock. Each one of us has a flock that we're responsible for, namely our children, and upon us is to teach them al-Islam. Yet many of us were sucked into the mindset that we don't want to push our kids too hard because we're afraid that we may push them away from Allah's deen. Even by doing what Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded, by teaching them the prayer when they're 7, spanking them lightly when they're 10 if they're not praying, so that when they hit puberty, they're praying already. And we say, oh, I don't want to push too hard, I'm afraid they'll go away. And yet, you let them run in the dunya, ravage and savage, until they have gone away on their own. But you are the one who actually thrust them into that. If you could give your child the best worldly gift, whether it's a nice car, or some money, or something they desire, or a nice home, or the best food and the best clothing, the nicest shoes, you would do it in a heartbeat. But when it comes to giving them the best thing that Allah gave you, that He gave you to give to them, to give to all of humanity, al-Islam, then you hold back, as if the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wasn't good enough. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Kullu mauludin yulidu ala al-fitra." Everyone who is born on the fitra, knowing that Allah is one and that He is the only one who should be worshipped. Kullu maulud, every single one, and then it's the parents that lead them down a different path, a different religion. Or in our case, we have Islam, but we may lead them down a watered down version of Islam. Or we may lead them down a modern version, modernized by you, as if your intellect or your wisdom or your whatever it may be is decent enough to tort or play or change the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهُمُ الْأَنْهَارِ وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي هَدَانَ لِهَذَا وَمَا كُنَّا لَنَهْتَدِيَ لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَ اللَّهِ لَقَدْ جَاءَتْ رُسُلُ رَبِّنَا بِالْحَقِّ وَنُودُوا أَنْ تِلْكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ أَوْرِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says what means, and we shall remove from their breasts any mutual hatred and sense of injury. This for the people of Jannah, which they had, if at all in the life of this world, rivers flowing underneath, under them. Better than any garden we can ever think we can plant or design. And they will say all praise and thanks to Allah who guided us to this deen and led us to this place of Jannah because we were upon it. Never could we have found guidance if it were not that Allah had guided us. Indeed, the messengers of our Lord did come with truth, and it will be cried out to them, this is the paradise, this is the Jannah that you have inherited by what you used to do. If you do not pay attention, every time we pray in the five times a day, if you just pray the five times, Surah Al-Fatiha is a must in every rak'ah. You have to read it. You have to read it. In it, we say every day at least 17 times if you do your five fard prayers. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Oh Allah, guide us to that straight path. How many of us other than the Fatiha ever ask Allah for tathbeet, for firmness on this deen, for guidance for us and our loved ones? How many of us ask for that other than the salah? But in the Fatiha, Allah in His wisdom, He made it part of the salah, so you're constantly asking for guidance to Islam. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. Guide us to the path of those who you favor, the path of those who you are pleased with, the path of those who you will grant mercy to and forgive them. The mufassirin, they go back to an ayah in Surah An-Nisa to clarify this statement of Surat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. Allah says, وَمَنْ يُتْعِ اللَّهُ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءُ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. Allah, He clarified in His book who are those who He favors, those whom He is pleased with. When He said in Surah An-Nisa, and whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you don't just obey Allah, you obey His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because this is obedience to Allah. You may say, who is this saying that of course we have to obey Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? If you only knew the foolishness, the sadness, the evil of some of those who claim Islam and they desert the sunnah of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then they will be in the company of those whom Allah has bestowed His grace. You obey Allah, you obey His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will be in the company in Jannah of those whom Allah has bestowed His grace on. The Anbiya, the Prophets, the Siddiqeen, the first to believe, including Abu Bakr and those followers of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Shuhada, the martyrs, and the righteous ones, and how excellent these companions are. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعو الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. Praise be to Allah. Praise and thanks be to Allah who guided us to this deen. And without Allah granting us His guidance, we would have never been upon it. Abdullah ibn Amr, he narrated that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, a man from my nation will be called on the day of resurrection in front of all of creation, with 99 scrolls put in front of him spread out. مَدَّ الْبَصَرِ, he can see each one of them the extent that his eyesight could see. ثُمَّ يَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلُّ هَلْ تُنْكِرْ مِنْ هَذَا شَيْئًا فَيَقُولُ لَا يَا رَبِّي فَيَقُولُ أَظَلَمَتْكَ كَتَبَتِي الْحَافِظُونَ ثُمَّ يَقُولُ أَلَكَ عُذْرٌ أَلَكَ حَسَنَةٌ فَيُهَابُ الرَّجُلُ فَيَقُولُ لَا فَيَقُولُ بَلَى إِنَّ لَكَ عِنْدَنَا حَسَنَاتٍ وَإِنَّهُ لَا ظُلْمَ عَلَيْكَ الْيَوْمِ. On that day, a man will be called in front of all of creation. 99 scrolls laid out on him, in front of him till he can see with his eyesight. Then Allah will say, do you deny any of this? From the sins you did in this dunya, all laid out in front of you. Nothing can be hidden. No lie can be told. He will say, no, O Lord. He will say, have my recording scribes, the angels on your shoulders, who were to write down your good and your bad, did they lie? Did they write down something they shouldn't? Did they say you did a sin you didn't commit? Then he will say, apart from that, do you have any good deeds? The man will be so terrified. He will say, la, ya Rab. He will say, no, I didn't do any good deeds because of the fear of knowing the amount of sins he did. Indeed, you have good deeds with us, and you will not be treated unjustly this day. فتخرج له بطاقة فيها أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله. قال فيقول يا رب ما هذه البطاقة مع هذه السجلات؟ فيقول إنك لا تظلم. فتودع السجلات في كفه في كف والبطاقة في كف. فطاشت السجلات وثقلت البطاقة. رواه ابن ماجه this hadith is sahih. Then a card will be brought out on which is written أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. A card will be brought out. Written on it, I bear witness that there is no God, nobody, no thing worthy of worship except for Allah alone without any partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his slave and his messenger. He will say, O Lord, what is this card that has this written on it compared to these scrolls of sins and bad deeds? He said, Allah said, you will not be treated unjustly. Then the scrolls will be placed on one side of the balance. And this card with this shahada will be put on the other side of the balance. And the scrolls will go up, made light in weight. And the card will go down because it weighs heavily. This is the ni'mah you have been blessed with. How can you hide it? How can you prevent your children from it? How can you not call to it? How can you not be firm upon it? How can you not run to Allah when you sin? How can you not look for deeds to do to please your Lord? What a blessing Allah has given us. If everything else was taken away from us, nothing replaces that card of this shahada. And we must always ask for Allah's firmness upon it. An Shahr ibn Hawshab, he narrated, he said, قَالَ قُلْتَ لِأُمِّ سَلَمَا يا أم المؤمنين ما كان أكثر دعاء رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كان عندك؟ قالت كان أكثر دعائه يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلبي على دينك. قالت قلت يا رسول الله ما إنه ليس قالت قلت يا رسول الله ما لأكثر دعائك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلبي على دينك؟ قال يا أم سلمة إنه ليس آدمي إلا وقلبه بين أصبعين من أصابع الله فمن شاء أقام ومن شاء أزاغ. This hadith which is Hasan in the Sunan of Tirmidhi. Shahr ibn Hawshab, he said, رضي الله عنه, I said to Umm Salama, O mother of the believers, what was the supplication the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say the most when he was in your presence, when he was with you? She said, he used to say the most when he was with me, O changer of the hearts, Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deenik, make my heart firm on your deen. The Messenger of Allah, the best of humanity, the best example for all of mankind, the one promised the highest of Jannah under the Arsh of Ar-Rahman. And here he is saying, O changer of the hearts, make my heart firm upon your deen. How many of you say it? How many of you taught it to your children? How many of you taught it to anybody? Let alone just asking for it for yourself. O change of the hearts, make my heart firm upon your deen. He said, O Umm Salama, verily there is afwan. So she asked him, so I said, O Messenger of Allah, why do you say this one so frequently? O change of the hearts, make my heart firm upon this deen. He said, O Umm Salama, verily there is no human being except that his heart is between the two fingers of Allah. And Allah, he has a hand. Allah, he has fingers. They are affirmed in the Quran, they are affirmed in the Sunnah of his Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَلَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. But Allah is not comparable to anything. He is not like his creation. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ. There is nothing like Allah or comparable to Allah. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. And he is the all-hearing, the all-seeing. So Allah, we affirm these attributes of the face, of the hand, of the fingers. But we do not change them to mean something else. They are as Allah said, but what they look like is not anything like our hands or any hand you could draw or think of. Do not change the sifat of Allah. Do not change Allah's attributes that He gave Himself or His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam affirmed for us. Back to it, he said, verily there's no human being except that his heart is between the two fingers of the fingers of Allah. So whoever he wills, he will make steadfast. Whoever he wills, he will cause to deviate. Ikhwani fillah, ibadallah, servants of Allah, my brothers in Islam, praise Allah daily. First and foremost for guiding you to this deen. Beg for him to not change your heart or turn it away from Islam. Because this deen, al-Islam, is the greatest, best, biggest gift and blessing and favor that you will have ever been given in your life. So praise Allah for it. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka anta samiyun qareebun mujibu ad-da'awat ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala dinik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala dinik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit quluban ala dinik subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina muhammad wa ala alihi